I came initially to the Lubavitch movement because of a remarkable phenomenon that I never saw anywhere else. I saw a whole group of Hasidim in the headquarters of Chabad, 770 Eastern Parkway, and they would pray on a Shabbat morning all the way through until 3, 4, or 5 in the afternoon. And it was then that I noticed something very remarkable, that the people who were praying were different people after they'd prayed to what they were before they'd prayed. And that to me was a bolt from the blue. I never thought the prayer could change your life, even visibly change your life. So that contact with the followers of the Hasidic movement was for me the most dramatic. It was later that I got to know the leader of that movement, the late Lubavitcher Rebbe, and I began to see how this one man had really influenced the lives of thousands of his disciples. What I saw in the Lubavitcher Rebbe was this, that other Jewish leaders that I've met created followers. The Lubavitcher Rebbe created leaders. I first met him when I was a 20-year-old undergraduate student at Cambridge University. And our first encounter, when I came to him with a lot of questions, was one that he turned around. He started asking me questions, challenging me, even at the age of 20, to be a leader of Jewish life. So what I found remarkable about him was the extent to which he could find in each individual the unique contribution that that individual could make to the totality of the Jewish people. That was a very rare skill. It was he who really encouraged me, or even ordered me, to become a rabbi. And one of the last requests I was able to make to him in his lifetime was whether I should undertake the chief rabbinate. And he answered in a way that was absolutely typical of him. He didn't say a word. He merely made a little mark on the letter that I had sent him. And the letter contained the question, should I take on this job? And he merely used the typographical symbol that reversed the words and said, I should. So he always communicated in a very brief way, but in a way that made you feel confident that he'd reached to the very heart of who you are, or at least who you might become.